few months ago, my student, let's call her Julie, and I were in lab waiting for her experiment to be done. Julie asked if we could go visit her grandma in a care home. I said, sure, thinking it would be a quick, pleasant visit. But when we entered in her grandma's room, something did not smell right. We found her grandma in a distressing situation. Her grandma needed a diaper change, and she didn't even realize it. Julie broke down in tears, devastated to see her beloved grandma in such a helpless condition. On our drive back, Julie shared stories about her grandmother. Her grandma was a passionate biology teacher who inspired generations of students. Her grandma loved attending graduation ceremonies and celebrating with her students. Julie is about to graduate with a degree in cell biology. But unfortunately, due to her grandma's health condition, her grandma won't be able to attend her own granddaughter's graduation. This moment stayed with me deeply. I started thinking about my own life. I could relate to Julie's grandma. I love science, specifically biology. I'm a molecular biologist, and over past 10 years, I have worked on fascinating projects, such as understanding how our body absorbs nutrients from our diet, and studying how our cells have developed their own FedEx system to take various proteins and lipids around. And during all this research, my focus has always been, what can we learn about biology so that we can improve our health and develop better drugs? Somewhat fascinated by the advances of modern medicine, I failed to see the crisis we have around us. I never actively thought about developing a chronic disease, but if something were to happen to me, I thought we had greatest healthcare to take care of everything. Then I thought about Julie's grandma. Doesn't she have so many amazing drugs available right now? Yet here we are with her grandma, unable to walk on her own or take care of even basic tasks. I'm a scientist, so I started looking at data. But the more I looked, the more horrified I became. Do you know that despite decades of vigorous research, our average life expectancy is still only about 78 years? Let's play out US Census Bureau's 2023 numbers. Imagine we are 100 people in this room and we are growing up together. Look around, these are your family and friends. When we approach around 75 to 78 years of age, only 10 of us would be here, only 10. 90 would be gone. One or two people may make it past 85 years, and by the time we approach 100 years, this room would likely be empty. What makes this situation even bleaker are our health span numbers. So health span is the duration of our life when we are generally healthy. As per CDC, half of the US population has currently at least one chronic condition, such as heart diseases, diabetes, arthritis, cancer. As per 2024 report from National Council on Aging, 95% people have developed a chronic condition by age 60. That's around the time we retire. To me, it means we are retiring right into a life with a chronic disease. And this health span crisis, it's not just affecting older population. The situation for our kids and adults is similarly bleak. The World Health Organization declared obesity a global epidemic in 1997, and the things have only gotten worse. As per last year's numbers from CDC, 1 in 5 kids and adults in US have obesity. Obesity isn't about just appearance concern. There are serious metabolic consequences associated with obesity. Almost every system in our body, our brain, heart, bones, reproductive organ, even our body's fighting power, immunity, is impacted by obesity. Currently, large US population is living with pre-diabetes, arthritis, high cholesterol. These aren't just numbers. They represent real people, real suffering, chronic, meaning long and constant conditions. Chronic diseases are silently stealing everyday joy from millions. Julie's grandma, who inspired so many students to become doctors, did she plan on missing her own granddaughter's graduation? No, we don't plan on our bleak future, but we are failing to realize by not making a decision for how we want the last 30 years of our life to be, we are making a decision, the decision of battling chronic diseases. But what if we could change this? As per World Health Organization and CDC, a large percentage of these chronic conditions could be prevented. Imagine a world where preventing chronic condition is a priority. Kids are no longer growing up with facing consequences of obesity, such as low energy, breathing problem, depression, bullying. Adults are no longer constantly struggling with infertility, worried about their pre-diabetes becoming diabetes, experiencing low energy, joint pains. Older adults are no longer strictly dependent on caregivers. Instead, kids are growing up healthy, full of energy. Adults are living active, fulfilling lives, accomplishing amazing things at work. And older adults, they are enjoying their golden years, traveling, learning, creating memories with their families. So what do we do to transform our society with the health span crisis into one where kids, adults, and older adults are thriving? What can we do to prevent these chronic diseases, which are largely preventable? Science-backed studies with millions of people, like Million Veteran Program, Diabetes Prevention Program, DASH Program, or NISH Program, have shown us exactly what kind of lifestyle changes can help us prevent these chronic conditions. There are also documentaries like Blue Zones on Netflix, which discusses lifestyle of people who are routinely living and thriving beyond 100 years. So let's take inspiration from these science-backed studies and design last 30 years of your life. Close your eyes and join me in picturing yourself as an 80-year-old. Wow, you are looking amazing for an 80-year-old. People often think you're in your 50s. You are halfway across the world on your dream vacation. You're sharing your pictures with your family, friends, even grandkids. Experience that freedom, that fulfilling experience, that happiness. You have healthy body, healthy metabolism, healthy brain, good energy. Hold on to this image of strong, happy 80-year-old you. Okay, open your eyes. And let's start developing your retirement account, 401k. Not for your finances, but for your health. Each day you have an opportunity to make deposits in this health account. And again, these are not monetary contribution, but lifestyle choices that compound over time, much like interest on a saving account. Just as you wouldn't wait till your golden years to start saving for retirement, you shouldn't wait till your later years to start investing in your own health. And the beauty of this health 401k, small incremental contribution can make significant returns. First and foremost, bringing balance and moderation to your diet. Currently, Americans are consuming large excess of fats, sugar, sodium, refined grains, and not enough of fibers, micronutrients, and whole foods. We could do day-long seminars about how ultra-processed foods may seem convenient but are associated with higher risk for chronic diseases. One simple strategy is start swapping ultra-processed food for natural foods. What? I hear some of you think, I love my pizza, I'm not giving that up. Good news, balanced diet isn't about deprivation, it's about balance and moderation. Enjoy that pizza, but pair that with salad and protein. One pizza meal doesn't lead to a chronic condition, but it's when breakfast of pancakes with heavy syrup, followed by pizza with chips, followed by pumpkin lattes happening over and over and over again, that's what finally pushes the system in imbalance. Watch, I can again hear some of you think, I'm not the type to change. The change doesn't have to be dramatic, remember, we are talking about small incremental steps. Start with one tiny habit. Instead of sugary pumpkin latte, try a coffee. See how that feels. I can tell you from my personal experience that these tiny habits are life-changing. I thought I was a stress eater. Anyway, Rocky Road ice cream was my best bud and the end of a stressful day. But the more I became aware of my choices and more my diet became balanced, I really don't need Rocky Road. I still see it in stores, and sometimes there are great discounts on it. I see it, and I smile, and I say, good for somebody else. I'm good. Overall, I feel so full of energy throughout the day and much more confident in my life. And this confidence has positively uplifted almost every aspect of my life. So give choosing food with awareness a try. And the second strategy is get moving. Only 1/4 Americans get enough physical activity as per CDC. The best way to get into the joy of exercising is just creating a new identity for yourself as an athlete. Doesn't matter what level of fitness you're at. Every month, try to do better than you did the month before. Set your own personal records and go on surpassing them. I know, diet and exercise, they sound too generic, but these are gold coins. Eating and moving around is something we do every day. All we have to do is tweak our daily habits to get maximum returns out of them. Even if you just follow balanced diet and regular physical activity, you can significantly change the trajectory of your health. I personally know so many people who are breezing in their 80s and 90s just by walking regularly and following balanced diet for past 40, 50 years. So where do we go from here? We go from idea to execution. Availability of solution isn't the problem. It's our inertia to embrace those solutions. That's the problem. We are living in an era of unprecedented scientific understanding. We know so much more about what causes diseases. We have so many tools available to monitor our own health in medical facilities, in smartwatches, or through apps. And the great news is there is rising awareness about longevity and health all around the globe. So join these online communities, in-person activities, and participate in health challenges. And the best of all, get your colleagues, friends, and family to participate in these health challenges. The takeaway of this talk is simple. Prioritize your health and take action. Not tomorrow, today, right this moment. I challenge you to identify one tiny habit, one deposit in your health 401k. It may seem insignificant now, but over time, this could be the difference between watching the life from sidelines and being an active participant in your golden years. These changes aren't about just adding years to your life. They are about adding life to your years. They are about ensuring you are not just surviving, but thriving now and in your future. I don't want to see any more grandmothers missing their own granddaughters' graduations. I don't want a world where those who once influenced communities and shaped industries find themselves robbed of dignity, reliant on others for even more personal aspect of life, like using a bathroom. I don't want to hear stories about lives cut short by preventable diseases. We have all the resources to prevent this. I really look forward to aging in thriving, amazing community around me. And do me a favor, when you grow up and cross the current threshold for lifespan and health span, look me up and send me a note about amazing things you're doing with your life and health. I would love to hear from you. Thank you.